What are some other cores who can kind of deal with it? You got an AA, you can always go a Spectre, you've got some global presence, but again, Spectre's not exactly bringing lockdown.
Spectre's scary to pick at the moment because they could still do some really aggressive lane with like the Quap and the Ogre, so they'd want to see more of the draft. You could go Ember here, which is a solid mid hero, or you could put it safe lane as well. I'm surprised he's still in the pool, to be honest, but...
Yeah, he's very strong right now. He was one of the few mid-heroes that didn't get nerfed, and instead it's a Windrunner. She certainly brings some lockdown to a party. If she gets a blink up, it's something where if she can blink Shackle Alchemist without Chemical Rage, he is nothing.
Windrunner's really strong against Elk. He's going to have to itemize like quite heavily on the Arm Effector to deal with her, and then there's the AA to worry about as well, so he's going to need a lot of items to do what he wants to do this game.
Yeah, so...
10 seconds
but,
remaining.
Yeah, we've got a Disruptor, and I feel like it's decent against the Windrunner. I'm not sure I see the easy setup for a Static Storm here, just with the heroes, so...
I think that they're taking into account how late the last game went, and they're picking supports that are able to be fed an Axe. And they're both pretty good this game. Like, Ogre can run into like Dazzle and AA and not care too much. Disruptor gives you a way of catching the Windrunner after she uses her Windrun to get away. And the Static Storm's really good at countering like Dazzle in fights if you can find him and get it on him.
Yeah.
And also, it's very hard to pick an offlaner into Quap, Ogre, and Disruptor. They have a very, very strong lane there. Bit aggro into it though.
It's a bit
punishable.
Okay. I was about to say, I don't think you want to aggro into this, but this is someone we haven't seen in a long time. Carry that has lockdown, you got to be careful with using it, make sure the Queen of Pain doesn't blink away. It's been ages since we've seen one of these guys though.
Void is like a very dead hero, it feels like. So I'm gonna guess it's Miracle's hero. It works really well with the heroes. Windrunner loves for lockdown, it gives setup for the AA. He can do a lot this game if he gets rolling, but it's not going to be easy to get rolling at all.
Radiant team. Yeah, it's like he needs a lot of items and it's really difficult, it feels like, but he should have a very safe lane. They have kill potential in their lane a little bit. At the same time, Alk is one of those heroes who gets six slotted really easily on, so I don't know what this Void is going to do there. If he catches out the Alk, he can certainly kill him, but if you're standing there taking Acid Spray and Radiance,
Yeah, the missed chance is going to be a problem. The Disruptor's like a really good hero against Void as well, because as soon as he leaps into Chrono, you just glimpse him away and then he has to run back and the Chrono's pretty much over by that point.
Yeah.
Ogre's got a really short range stun though, so if you position it well, it's hard for him to help out whichever hero you catch. The Quaps don't normally go like a CC item. She could go Yules, but again, the range on that has been nerfed, so you could get away with it.
Mm-hmm.
But as far as their last pick here goes, I'm not sure what offlaners are left that they'd want. There's six of them being banned out. They could do like Slaughter maybe as their offlane hero.
I really think Slaughter's fantastic, kind of. I don't want to say no matter what, but it feels like Slaughter's really strong. The amp damage is ridiculous. It just buffs up everyone.
Oh yeah, and if you run Slaughter Ogre into what I'm presuming is going to be Void AA Dazzle, they have a hard time with that because you're just two really tanky frontline heroes that can run at their supports. They can't stop you. They might be able to kill you if you really misplay and overstay, but they have the ability to put a lot of pressure. Similar thing with Centaur, I guess.
I don't...
That is an Omni.
Okay, so I actually have experience with the offlane Omni. It gets picked a lot in games that I cast. It's very popular... Well, it's very popular on specific teams in NA Dota, so... He certainly...
Sorry, go on.
Oh, I was just gonna say, So here's the thing about the offlane Omni. He does really well. If he's up against the Centaur, if they can find that lane, he's gonna do fantastically. It's harder. Like, he does really well against people like a Gyro and so on, but he doesn't exactly do fantastically against a Quap, right? She can dodge the purification. The whole deal of this offlane Omni is that you purify someone in the face. It's purification is pure damage. It's a big AoE. It's actually, if he's... Okay, he hasn't skilled yet, but it's actually a bit bigger AoE than you think. And sometimes you just run up to people with degen and give them the purify. I don't know how it's going to fare up against a Quap, though, if that's a lane he's facing.
They could look to do the one-on-one against Centaur just to make sure he gets levels and farm. Like, I don't think he'll win the lane necessarily, because Centaur is...
Do you see what they're doing?
I think he has more kill potential. Running to...
Yeah, Mineski's running a really gross lane. It's Queen of Pain, Ogre Magi. That is, get harassed. Take some Ignite, take some Shadow Strike. So. I wasn't expecting that one. I'm not quite sure how I was exactly expecting these lanes to shape up, but that's a really nasty lane. Anyway, let's introduce the players. I think last time I did First Departure, so I'm stealing Mineski this time. We've got Jules on that Disruptor, who may run headfirst into a bunch of the enemies. We got Ogre Magi on Jesse Vash. We've got Cuckoo on that Queen of Pain. Not Queen of Pain. We've got Alchemist being played up by Bimbo or Raging Potato. And finally, the the Centaur being played by Ryor. So, tossing it to you for this First Departure no latch gank.
We have Miracle on the Faceless Void, Kel on the Omni, Fixers on the Windrunner or Windranger, Lubby on the Dazzle, and Kai on the AA. It looks like there's a huge lane swap coming out. They want to try and contest the rune, but I don't think Void's going to be able to do anything.
Backup. Even with the Omni, though, oh gosh, it's just a matter of who can actually stand on here and click this. Miracle taking a lot of damage. Who gets it? Void does. That's huge. Win your lane without that first bounty. And now Raging Potato taking a lot of damage as well. Void's going to slow him down. Oh gosh, a first death here for Mr. Alk. You can't sustain that. Another purification. One more auto attack. That is the purification spam we were talking about. Miracle may go down, but Tony got first and second blood. Omni Knight. Are they actually going to kill anyone here? Jesse Vasha gets a kill, but now he has to suicide himself. No, he's going to walk away. He should be able to walk it off from lobby. Disastrous fight for Mineski. Maybe going to be a bad start again. And without that first bounty rune, Raging Potato loses this lane. He has no bottle.
Yeah, he's going to need to ferry out another set of tangos ASAP so he can actually stay in this lane and deal with the harass. But that's like such a game-winning start for FD. Getting the bounty away from the elk and then getting two kills on top of that is really big.
Yeah.
And maybe they predicted the, like, lanes from Mineski because they sent the Void bottom, not wanting to deal with the Quap and Ogre aggressively.
Yep. I think this is great. The Void is going to get a lot more farm. Yeah. Although he is taking a lot of damage right now.
The supports definitely need to be there, but if they do rotate down, then they win 2 out of 3 lanes, I think. Which is a winning setup in general.
Yeah. No. We've got some interesting rotations coming out. A popping his head middle. I'm not quite sure whether A wants to go top. I agree with you, though. It feels like you put the supports with Miracle. He has a good time. Oh, Raging Potato.
A has a mango as well.
Yeah, I think that makes sense. A lot of your spells are really expensive, mana-wise.
I feel like that's just money you could spend on centuries. I don't know.
There's that, too. But
every time... I think of getting a mango as support, I'm like, wait, I actually need to buy support items.
Yeah. I think they sacked the Dazzle quite a bit from the looks of things, and wanted the AA to maybe get a little bit more farm. So, but in mid lane, we have a very poor Alchemist. I think he actually did a stack, or he went to go stack something up, and now he gets a bounty rune. Finally, he can buy something.
Least.
Yeah.
They're actually going double bottle with the Quap picking one up as well.
Oh my goodness, they get a bash and a teal bomb onto Jesse Vasha. He has to be really careful. The Shadow Wave is in cooldown again in 7 seconds, so... But, gonna be no thing. After those early kills, game calming down. Okay, so let's talk about overall game plans here, because Alk, yeah, he gets 6 slotted really early on, but he doesn't actually have a heap of damage, and neither does a Queen of Pain or a Centaur, right? Like, you're not exactly physical damage clickers.
No, but Centaur does like a very high amount of burst damage, and Quap can follow it up really well. And Elk's just I think he's deceptive on his damage. If he actually gets farm early, like you get Treads and Radiance by 15, which is a pretty slow timing, but I'd say it's doable in most games. You hit for like 120, which is good enough.
And there is always the factor of you can do that, like you play the Alc like the Naga Siren build that's gotten popular with Radiance and Octarine, where you just push out lanes, sorry, Manta as well. So, Ryo might take a heal bomb to the face if he's not careful. Okay, he is careful. But yeah, Miracle's just gonna
pop in top. This could actually be a kill.
Oh no, what did she do? She does manage to get the kill, but she goes down as well. Not super worth it, although as an offlane quap, maybe okay.
The levels on the AA are gonna be like a big factor this game. He got solo experience for the quap, which was level 5. That's a huge deal. I'd almost say it's worth it losing the Omni for that.
Yeah, it's the same as when your mid dies. Sometimes it's actually better if a support had rotated in to get the kill on the opposing mid. Even if your mid dies, as you point out, you just got a bunch of levels on a hero that otherwise might not have had their ult until minute 14. So, AA pretty happy with that.
Yeah, ult this game's gonna be really big. Mostly for the Alc, but the other heroes aren't that tanky when they get hit by it.
Yeah, and it doesn't.
The bounty as well.
Yeah, it doesn't feel like they actually have. So they've got all of this armor coming out of Weave, and Omni Knight has, of course, GA to stop physical damage. Oh gosh, Queen of Pain, you need to blink. He does. It doesn't feel like they have a lot of physical damage coming out of Mineski, though. As we talked about, yeah, Alc can hit for quite a bit with Chemical Rage with a few items up, but other than that, your magic, your damage is all magical. Oh, a nice Shackle coming out in mid lane. She has a DD as well. Can she get this with a power shot? If she gets a couple more lucky right clicks, he needs to dodge this power shot. He does. And she takes quite a few tower hits. She may go down here if he has anything he doesn't have on Stable Concoction. He just gets her!
That's a really big misplay.
Yeah, so Fixer's, I think he just went in a bit too far. Didn't pop the Windrun there when he should have to avoid the tower shots.
He popped it to get more attacks in from the Dire's middle tower. He started on his hill when he hit the Shackle, Dire's and then he Windruns forward to get more orb orbs.
Oh, okay.
Which he needed to do that to get the kill. And I think even if he hit the power shot, he wasn't going to get the kill. So he's just trying to force it too much. Which is a really bad thing to have happen. This Alc does not need to have a good start for Mineski to do well this game.
So we were talking about how Mineski has a lot of magical damage, maybe not as much physical. Right click. Do you think you itemize your quap maybe a bit differently, or are you still going that maybe Orchid if you get a very early start, but probably just Ags, maybe Octarine later, maybe BKB, depending on how the game goes?
Well, I don't think it's a problem they don't have too much physical damage, because other than Repel being on a hero, they're all pretty squishy. Sure, they have the Omni to heal them up, but if you get bursted down by Centaur and Quap, you don't really have time for the heal unless you're right on top of them.
Yeah.
So the magical damage is going to be enough for a long period of the game, and by that time, the Alc and Quap should be able to scale. I can see like the Quap going for an Orchid this game, as opposed to the items you were saying earlier, and probably transitioning to like an AC if the Alc doesn't want to get that.
Yeah.
They're actually going on the AA here.
They are trying to give it a go. They have the Shadow Strike as well, and the Sonic Wave. Quap is already level 6. She can just use it here if she wants. There's a Shackle shot, though, and she's going to get Cold Feet. She does get off the Sonic Wave, but she also goes down to the Windrunner, and this is really scary. Is Alc going to rotate at all? It looks like Jesse Vosh should be able to walk it off. They're both. It's a very slow-moving chase, and yeah, Jesse Vosh gets away. So Quap gets another kill at the expense of her life. I think fantastic for the Windrunner.
Yeah, the Windrunner is not having the... Actually, never mind. She's doing pretty well, despite
her
death.
Yeah, she's doing fine. It just looks like the Alc's doing a lot better because of stuff like Grievel's Greed, so...
He just picked up a Midas as well, which I'm kind of surprised about. But I guess he understands that he's gonna need a lot of items.
Oh, we have Miracle. He's on bottom lane taking a lot of damage, but without the Sonic Wave, I don't know if they can do it. Miracle also does have a Time Walk, so he's gonna get glimpsed back and then just Time Walk away, I imagine. Do they have any sort of jump afterwards? Now they're going on Dazzle. The Cold Feet should proc on Queen of Pain. There it is. She's stunned up. Now they have the Repel onto Miracle. He can go a bit more ham, not have to worry about Centaur Hoofstomp. And there's the ultimate coming out, but I don't know if this is the target you wanted to go on. Quap seems like an easier kill, but they get the Shackle, they're gonna get both! And that was a really nice kill coming out of them to get those two. Feels like an overextension by Mineski.
I actually wasn't sure if FD were gonna get both kills there, because they focus different targets, but getting both is really big.
This Windrunner has been really active, all things considered.
It's definitely a game where she can. Other than the ogre, and I guess for Glimpseback, there's not too much stopping her from just running amok on heroes. And they're actually looking to push down bottom, I think. They're rotating all heroes. The Windrun is moving away though, so she probably wants the rune first.
Goodbye, Ogre Magi. He actually gets lucky. Windrun is coming in though. No, he did not juke the right way. There's going to be a shackle shot as well. He does stun her up, so he gets rid of the cold feet, but there's plenty of shackles. She's going to try to auto attack him down. I actually think with an Ogre Magi, you have to shackle shot him. Yeah, they might lose this kill because of this, and this actually alleviates some pressure on bottom, although I still think that's in a lot of trouble. Another power shot, maybe? No, it's going to miss. Yeah, you were right. Ogre was fine.
Not easy to hit.
So, Miracle getting another heal bomb thrown on him, but Faceless Void does get the tower. Now they're going on to pull Little Disruptor. He pops up a kinetic field, but I don't know if that's enough. There are also heal bombs. There's another one coming out. No, they use the GA instead. Now there's no mana on the Ogre on the Omni Knight. So, Jules. Oh gosh, he died. He died to the Queen of Pain. I was following Jules. Jules, I still think, is going to go down. No mana for a TP, but can he juke enough? There is the Centaur Stampede. They've got a stun. Jules, they need one more auto attack on him. They get it, but Dazzle might fall here. Two Shallow Grave comes out. Jesse Vasha, he has a million armor, but he still might go down. Oh, the Poison Touch doing a lot of damage. Can Quap find the kill here? She has the blink. She's going for the blink. She gets the Sonic Wave. Sorry, the Scream. And the Ogre Magi gets out. But now Cuckoo, he's going to be trapped up in here with Miracle. Oh, Miracle almost didn't kill off Cuckoo. There we go. The slow, inevitable death of the Queen of Pain. So, really nice for Miracle. And is this just a Mask of Madness game?
At least the Morbid Mask is really good, so you can sustain yourself when you're farming in the woods. But Mask of Madness is a pretty much core on that hero, I think.
It seems a bit scary, this game, I feel, just because they have stuff like multicast, Sonic Wave.
It's definitely not something you pop in a fight. Like, you use it to farm, you use it to be more efficient and maybe get some solo kills with it, but you do have to be very careful with it this game, for sure.
Yeah.
Not something you want to, like, go in and expect to pop it every fight. This Elk is really fat. Like, he's gonna have a similar timing on his Radiance, despite the fact he also picked up a Midas.
Yeah, and looks like Queen of Pain, she needs to walk it off. She actually blinks away on that one, so... Miracle is farming his opponent's jungle, as you said, has that Mask of Madness up. And not sure what we're gonna see next out of people. Oh, they actually go in on Queen of Pain. They pop the ult and she's just dead.
It's really hard when you're playing against a Void that just got his Mask of Madness creds at such an early time.
That's and the AA Blast is up in middle. It looks like Jules going down. They don't even need that AA Blast.
I was actually just about to say how good of a start the AA had on levels. I was surprised he wasn't level 6, but he got it off that kill.
Yep.
Which is really good. Now they can start, like, actually putting some pressure.
Oh, they actually popped the Centaur ult, trying to go on the repelled Omni Knight. They might have some backup here, but instead, just doing some stacks. The Alk stealing his opponent's stacks. What are a stacking status? Well,
that's
the stacking
really
status is not much. It was just one stack, it was a double. It wasn't like he stole a trip or something.
Yeah, but every... little
every
helps,
bit counts,
sure.
Yeah. Especially for an Alk, but right?
Instead of that being 200 gold, that's more like 450 or something, maybe even more.
Yep. And it's going to took from his opponents. Yeah, it looks like we've got a glimpse back. That's going to stop your TP. Hoof stomp as well. That doesn't care about your Windrun. And yeah, a nice kill there. Will the AA Blast hit? Oh gosh, he walks out of it. Ryo just getting out in time. So this game action-packed, a lot of people having a lot of kill-death involvement early on. Quap is 5-6, Void is 4-1, Windrunner is 2-2-2, as is Omni Knight. Like, this is really a lot of rotations, I feel, a lot of movement from heroes early on.
Yeah, which I feel like it's a bit weird that FD are getting off to such a good start, considering the fact that heroes feel a bit more passive.
Really?
Like
I think that
earlier,
they have good sustain in a lot of these engagements because they have so much heal.
Yeah, the Omni Knight's like so hard to fight into.
Yeah.
And Void's like, if you get...
Oh, they're going for it! Raging Potato has gone down elsewhere, but with the Static Storm. Can they kill him off though before the cooldown? Yeah, they've got him. I was worried that Static Storm might end before they killed him and they just catch him out.
That should trigger that there's a ward there though, because they did that before they had vision of him, I think.
Yeah. And so Alk managed
Miracle
to
lets his team know.
Alk managed to buy the relic before he died, so the kill on Bimbu a bit too late. I'm pretty sure he didn't lose any gold because of that. Quap comes in. Does she have the Sonic Wave? She does, but she needs to back out a little bit. Stampede helping her escape Power Shot, bringing her super low. They need someone to go in on Fixers, but here it comes. There's the Blink Hoof Stomp, and now Fixer is taking a lot of damage. There was an AA Blast. There's the Sonic Wave, but it doesn't matter. It wasn't quite enough with the Purification. And of course, it does go through Repel, but Windrunner not taking anything else there. So I thought that was going to be a good fight for Mineski after that beautiful hoof stomp on 3. Not enough.
I'm really surprised he has his blink already. It felt like he wasn't having the best of games, but I guess I was too busy watching other heroes.
Yeah, I think he got... Oh, he goes for another hoof stomp, immediate Repel out. So Windrunner wants none of that business.
They need to just like let FD like do what they want with the Omni if they're grouping up, and let your Elk farm elsewhere. Because there's no way they can deal with the Repel right now, especially with Static Field on cooldown. And just the healing general, like their burst is mitigated if he's in range to cast. Yeah.
So, gonna be all in all a good fight or good hold. But yeah, as you said, I think this means the tower goes down. They do have glyph. They're gonna just pop it. They'll get it refreshed in a second. And in the meantime, Miracle, he actually has taken quite a bit of damage from the tower and the acid spray. He has to be a little bit careful there, but as you said, nobody wants to contest. So this is, I think the Alc build is kind of solidified after the mages and MLG. You just seem to always go Radiance, Octarine, Manta. Sorry, Manta, Octarine. Be a Naga.
It's really good this game if he can actually make the like Naga Siren quote-unquote build work, because there's one or two heroes that you definitely want to feed the eggs to, and I feel like after you get Manta, and depending on the game, Octarine as well, you can at least pull one egg someone, and this game I think it would have to be the Disruptor.
Yes.
Because his ult is going to be so huge.
And he can't get one.
Yeah, like, as soon as Void gets his BKB, he doesn't care about Disruptor, but in about 15 minutes, when the Alk's got his two items that we said earlier, and then he probably has enough to pull the Disruptor as well, then the Void doesn't, like...
Oh gosh, they catch the Faceless Void, a miracle again. Again, though, they're having a bit of trouble doing the damage. He might be able to get out of the Static Storm this time. They need some sort of follow-up. He pops his ult. He's actually going on Ryo, but this may cost him his life. Power Shot gets the kill. An A-Blow's coming in as well to help out. So Miracle, I think he's going to be just fine, and was Glimpse... Yeah, they used it as well. I was also going to say, hey, he had a 14-minute Midas, much better than the 28-minute one we saw last time.
Was it even that quick last game?
It was 28 minutes. Lot longer. No, that game was just a lot longer.
Miracle Manning up there as well was really good game presence. He knew they didn't have the damage, and the Windrunner Power Shot was able to finish off, I think it was the center that he was hitting. Good presence of mind there, and that really fucks with Mineski's ability to fight for the next 40 seconds. Losing a kill there, not getting
any. Oh, but they get the bad thing. Oh, okay. I don't know if you saw, but he was farming with Mask of Madness, and Ogre Magi came in, did Ogre Magi things, actually got the stun. Now they're going in more. They don't have the Sonic Wave here because they just used it on Miracle. But can they get the kills? The Radiance, it is active. Does he have it on him? Yes, he does. And they kill one. They should be able to kill two. Fantastic team fight from Mineski. They got four. I didn't even catch one of those, and suddenly turning it around after what the early lead by a first departure.
Yeah, I think that's just the players fighting me. But it was really smart by the Disruptor to glimpse a Windrunner, even though there was a Dazzle TPing out in her face, in his face. It's like going for the bigger kill was definitely worth it. Now they're going to get the tier 1 off it as well. Yeah. Kind of negates the point I was making earlier, because now they probably have the strength to burst heroes down if they're ahead.
Oh, we have a glimpse backwards and a centaur stampede. We have Miracle coming from behind. He's going in. Is there going to be an ult? There's going to be an AA blast. I don't know if they want to stay here. This is probably going to be a very dead disruptor. One more auto attack should do it, although he is very small health. No, he does shatter. It's always hard to tell because, you know, the percentage threshold is low, and oh gosh, is this going to be a self-stun? He can't get it off the repel. Will it wear off in time? It does stun both of them, but he doesn't suicide. Probably really upset there that he can't. Oh gosh, he misses! He misses the auto attack! Yeah.
That was really unfortunate that he didn't he didn't suicide.
Yeah, I mean, it was really close. So, almost a nice, perfect play from Bimbo, but unfortunately goes down.
I'm pretty sure if he didn't have the armor from the band, he might have died there. It was that close.
Oh yeah, because unstable. Yeah. Shouldn't have picked up extra agi for armor. Well played, but either way, we are looking around. He's still way out on the net worth chart. Of course, that is a good kill for first departure, just because of how the rubber band effects works. You kill the top hero, you get a good amount of net worth back. Okay, it looks like he's going Aghanim's on Faceless Void. Thoughts? And a Midas on Omni.
I think that's pretty good this game actually, because the lower cooldown chrono means they can be much more active and they want to put pressure on the elf. Because right now, like, he might have 3k more net worth than the Void, but he's effectively useless with the item build he's gone. He's going to be able to, like, come in and clean up if he's not the one initiated on.
Yeah.
But it's not how they've been playing. Like, he's been there to defend the towers. He's kind of been the person in the fights, I feel like. And when you have the chrono to, like, keep putting pressure and killing him so he can't get more items, then it puts FD in a better position.
Yep. So, I like it. It also will help set up a lot of nice AA blasts, and you can, of course, always repel whoever's in the chronosphere, so lots of damage coming up there. Sorry, not repel, purification them. Big heal bomb. And power shot. Windrunner, she- okay, Fixers has been having a bit of trouble hitting the power shot, so chrono- more chronospheres, more power shots.
If you charge it, though, it's really easy to know where it's going, and you can
yeah,
move it.
Yeah, it's an
away
easily choreographed spell, and that's why it's hard for a Windrunner to hit. Now, it looks like Ryo may be going for a pipe. I know Cup buffed,
yeah,
Lost
like,
Patch.
Yeah.
So, I think it's good against AA.
Yep, yeah, definitely. Helps against the Void's bash damage as well, a bit in the chrono.
not maybe the major thing, but... yeah, but it's something also where if you can get the pipe off before, maybe your whole team takes it. Oh, gonna realize the Ancients are blocked here for Bimbo. If you find out that the... Sorry, if you get the pipe off before your whole team takes an A loss in a chronosphere, yeah, you'll take what you can get, even if it's a little bit of dodging bash magical damage. So... okay, so Aghanim's up on Quap. She bought one herself, wasn't fed one by the trusty alchemist, but that makes sense. She wants hers much earlier than he is willing to give her one. We've... oh, that's a fun net worth graph. We've also got half of the pipe out on Centaur. Ogre Magi has a Ghost Scepter. I like this. And bots on Mr. Potato. I think he had them before and I was just not... Dire's
top tower. Yeah, he got them when he died earlier. But they're shoving top in with the... Mineski heroes, but FD realize this and they're going to take the classic trade of tier 1 for Roche.
Yeah.
I'm not even sure they'll get the tier 1 though before Roche goes down.
What do you build? Oh, yeah, they might not get it, but I think also this means Mineski's looking in the jungle maybe for a pick and don't realize that it's just the Roshan. So.
Yeah, you could tell they were really scared of hitting the tower and then they realized it was Roche and they're probably thinking, oh shit, we should have been taking this.
Yep. So, gonna miss out on taking that teamfight. Maybe they can do something to an Omni Knight. They have a glimpse ready. It is nighttime, though. Oh, he gets the kinetic field, but he doesn't quite latch, and there's gonna be another repel. So, they do get the tower. They take an AA blast to the face, and Alk has to be a little careful. Oh, yes. It looks like.
He has a chemical rage first. He might actually survive.
Never mind, but Jesus. Oh, it's gonna kill him. He wished he didn't use it there.
And he nearly has his Manta as well, if he didn't die there. He has the recipe already.
Yeah.
So every time you kill him, that's like so big of a deal. He's dead for 50 seconds, and he's probably able to get 2 or 3,000 gold in the time it takes for him to next go out and like deal with planes, so...
Yeah, oh, we got a Sentinel Stomp. They want to go on Miracle, knowing that his ult is down and Sonic Wave. They used a bunch of ulties, though, for an Aegis, and I don't know how worth it that was. Yeah, you got it off the map really fast, but Miracle can still go fight here. There's the Repel coming out, and they don't have anything to deal with this. They just lost a mid-tower for all of their ults being down.
Yeah, they needed to defend in their mind, but I think they could have just, like, tried to push out other lanes, because that tower's dead.
Yeah.
When you look at it like that. And getting the Aegis off... the Void is not a bad thing because it's going to prevent them going for further tower pushes like that, but now they're just going to look for pickoffs with the next chrono because it's up now. They aren't going to want to push tier 3s into an Elk yet. They're going to wait for at least next set of items and probably Roche.
Yeah, we also have AA already halfway to his Aghanims at 22 minutes in.
He's doing really well this game.
So that's a fat AA. I don't want to say that Mineski's out of it, but it just looks like a lot of things are going well for First Departure right now. And the Alk maybe isn't as far enough ahead.
Yeah, the Void pick has definitely like thrown off what they wanted to do. It was a really smart draft by FD. And the Omni is just enabling them to take fights that you feel they otherwise wouldn't be able to. And he even got away of going for a Midas.
Yeah, he has a
So
full
he's been.
staff on the way as well. I was gonna ask you, what do you go? You're an Omni with a Midas. I mean, do you build up you're probably waiting for the Dazzle to get the Solar Crest, but what other utility items do you go for your team?
I kind of prefer Blink over Force, but I can see for like forcing people out of Centaur stuff, and they're actually going to kill the Centaur mid with Chrono, and they waste the AA blast. But Axe, I don't think it's that good this game, so you'd probably look for something more like a Lotus Orb to either reflect the stuns or just purge them off. Could still go Blink on top of his Force as well, though.
Yeah, and I wonder. I think the blink is always really nice. You can blink in, blow a lot of those spells, save a teammate.
Positioning's really hard on that hero because the ranges are so short.
Yeah. We can see the cost ranges aren't the biggest. So, what do you do as well? If you're this Ogre Magi, I like the Ghost Scepter pickup, right? That's clearly for the Faceless Void, but it feels like he needs more. Maybe a Glimmer Cape, maybe a Force Staff. And they're going. They do manage to get the Shackle, and he's repelled. There's nothing the Ogre Magi can do here except stand, and it looks like Quap, she's gonna get away with 200 health. And no follow-up from Ogre Magi.
Yeah, this Windrun is just being able to actually do things this game, which makes a big difference. Last game, it felt like if he was much more relevant, FD would have had a much easier time. But he's playing really well this game.
Now, Sentinel, he's going to look for a big hoof stomp, but it turns daytime, and I think he realizes he's seen and backs out. So, how can Mineski get themselves back into this game? It really does feel like they're falling behind in a lot of different ways. They don't have the lockdown. Yeah, Alk can get really big and farm, but as we talked about, he's not. He has the Manta. Gonna use
I
it for a
feel
little
like
split pushing.
they're gonna have to do similar to what they did last game, where they try and cut creep waves and just like dodge the 5-man of FD, and maybe have your supports farming in really greedy positions to tank the ganks with the Chrono is better than having the Alk die. But the Void's fat enough that he doesn't need to Chrono if he finds a support, so it's kind of awkward at this point. I don't think 5-manning is a good way to go either, because FD win the 5-man.
Yeah,
They
it feels
actually
like they have
buy.
much better team fight because of the Guardian Angel, the Repel, the Purifications, and the Dazzle Heals. I mean, they have so much sustain in a 5v5, and speaking of a 5v5, we're gonna have at least a 3v3 up top. Oh, he pops the Chrono! He actually does get the Disruptor, though! And this is fantastic, right on the edge. Oh, he actually. Okay, there we go. Finishes him off. Now.
That's good though.
Yeah.
60 second cooldown for one kill is definitely worth. They're not going to want to fight for the next 50 seconds, so they're just going to chill, push out lanes. And this is where Mineski could look to do something now it's on cooldown, if they were like to smoke and look for a pick. But they're opting not to. They want to push out the lanes, get the Alk's farm. Because he can still play, turn this game around, but it's not easy for him at all.
Quap.
His 18k net worth is kind of negated by the fact they have an AA.
Yeah. So, Quap also going a Yules. What is that for?
Probably to blink in and either Yulz the Omni or the Dazzle so they can actually kill the target they're looking to burst, or so he can Yulz when Void blinks in, jumps in to Chrono him, so he can blink away.
Radiant's Yeah, top but tower is I don't know if it's
attack.
too little too late. Of course, you can often repel the Faceless, and there is a smoke. I think it's been spotted though. Orange has drawn a big circle around this smoke. But looks like Quap's gonna walk right into this smoke regardless, and there is another Chronosphere up, so Quap, she is right on top of a ward, about to be dead unless she blinks the right way. Oh gosh, there's a Centaur Stampede, they're actually going over onto the Disruptor again! And he's one of the few who can lock down Miracle with that Static Storm combo. Queen of Pain doing some work. Oh, there's a nice Centaur Stomp, but at the same time, there's a Repel. AA Blast gonna land, I don't know if this is gonna be enough, and if they win this team fight right here, they could go for high ground. There's gonna be heals coming out of Cal, and Ogre Magi, it looks like he needs one or two more hits, does use that Ghost Scepter now. We've got a lot of damage going out on Miracle. Another power shot. Goodness gracious. And Miracle's repelled, taking nothing.
Yeah, I guess they don't want to go for Rosh. Sorry, the high ground push right now. They're scared of
Yeah, they don't have Aegis.
Giving away their advantage. AA's gonna finish his axe. He's 70 gold away, which is really important this game. Void has some Mjolnir, which is really good farm. Dazzle also has a gem, so they're gonna try and take map control, chill for the rush, and probably look to end next Aegis, or at least take a set of racks. I don't think Mineski would care about one. Their lineup can scale late.
It's kind of interesting as well. It does feel like Mineski They're just in a really bad spot here. Similar to last game, how they lost the early game, but this one, the siege looks so much easier with a Windrunner, with a Faceless Void. You can just go harass their backlines while your Windrunner takes their tower with Focus Fire.
Yeah, the Omni also just makes it so much easier. I remember playing with this hero, and it just makes your game so much easier. Like, you can allow for mistakes with this hero being in your draft.
Both the Omni and the Dazzle are allowing them for it. It's not
Miracle
easy
might
mode.
Die here, though.
Well, as you say that,
like,
yeah.
Yeah, is, so.
I don't know if they'll be able to catch him out, and they will have to commit the Static Storm. Oh, he's gonna see them with the ward, though. Oh, he doesn't actually use the blink. There's the... Oh, gosh. They have anything for him? No, nothing to stop Miracle. They actually get the stun out of him. But there's the AA Blast on Raging Potato, and that's not what you want. Gonna be a go forward by Miracle, and let's see if they have anything else up to them. Oh, gosh. Cuckoo. What is he doing? He does use the Sonic Wave, but it doesn't even kill off Omni Knight. Now, Cuckoo trying to go in on somebody else, but he has no backup. He has to blink away, and Miracle can follow him here. Does he get the bashes? He doesn't. He gets Yulzed up. Cuckoo still needs some backup. There's gonna be a Windrunner, no Shackle latching, but just with all of the auto attacks, that's a dead Quap, and I think they feel very comfortable. They might wait a wave. It looks like they would rather pick off Alk up top, but...
Nah, they can go here for sure.
Yeah, there's gonna be the TP in, but again,
that's
Miracle,
really
he has...
Yeah,
he has 15 seconds on his ult as well. They're trying to use these illusions to do something, but they're just not strong enough, they don't hurt far enough. He's trying to also throw the stun onto someone. Oh gosh, there's nobody to throw the stun on. Again, self-stun. A-Blast as well gonna hit, and Raging Potato is down. I don't want to say it, but I think we've got a very short game on our hands. They can just work on this tower. Miracle's still going in hand. He's healed back up. Alkvi's back, but it's not enough. There's a repel on Miracle. They have nothing to stop this guy. Where is the Static Storm? It's on cooldown. So
yeah,
a weave coming out?
Well.
Oh. I actually think they should have gone for Rax there, maybe get the Windrunner in on this business, but her Focus Fire is down, so...
It's probably smarter to shelf, because I don't feel they'd have taken the Rax in the next 10 seconds, and the Quap coming back with ulti is scary. They can look to, like, do what they're doing now, just sit on the high ground, and wait for Mineski to push out and catch them with a Chrono. Unfortunately, they didn't see the ward on the high ground next to the tier 2. So Mineski know what's up.
Now, you're a Void rocking a lot of money. You're really fat. Like, this Void is. What do you build item-wise? Do you get a BKB just to not worry about stuff anymore?
I think you get crit. Or
you get crit. Maybe. So you're just going full greed. I mean, you actually
you have
a lot of health with the Yags.
Yeah.
And with all the heals. So you're just gonna take a ranged Rax 30 minutes in, a bit different than last game, actually getting the push. There's a Hoofstomp Miracle, it goes down, they finally kill him off! That's a big kill for them! They need to win this rest of the team fight, though, a beautiful Shackle, but Windrunner, she doesn't decide to follow up on it and force stuff away, they can't catch Cal here! They need anything to catch him! There's gonna be the glimpse back on Lobby, they'll at least get that guy, will they? Yeah, they will stop the TP out, but... I mean,
that's
yeah,
a gem
you...
as well.
Oh, okay, gem, that, I think, making it more worth it.
Yeah, it was really smart of them to go for the gem target instead of the Omni, because they could have gotten one or the other.
Yeah.
Getting the gems gonna give them a way to, like, secure some of their own woods.
So,
And FD won't feel so confident when they don't have their vision up anymore.
Yeah, and it's like a 2900 gold swing for them. They're still behind, but they're certainly making some good progress back in. It's also really bad, though. Your Alk is 4k net worth ahead, and you're behind. Raging Potato, Bimbo, trying to work on that top tower. Ugh. Okay, I don't want to... I'm not saying Mineski is bad, by any means. I feel like they have done... clearly shown us they know how to do some good things in both games. But it feels like this game and last game, they had lost early... You know, they had lost the early game.
I'm not really sure what you can attribute that to, though, because losing the Bounty Rune on Alk is... really big, and fighting into an Omni Knight is really hard. Like, you have to be ahead, and even then it's hard. So maybe it's just like a lack of understanding that they shouldn't have fought into him.
Disrupt is making his own Aghanims, that's so rude.
I think, like, they understand the situation where the Elk needs to be his own hero to actually have a presence in these fights.
Yeah.
I don't like it either, but like, I think it's definitely the better decision than trying to buy Ags for your team.
And Sentinel's building a defusal. Is under attack. And he's going to take an AA Blast to the face.
Yeah.
That should be fine, because I don't... Is it Aghanims? It is Aghanims, never mind. It's only level 2, though. And they're going to take a quick Roshan on first departure. So once again, just like last game where they were dire, complete Roshan control. We got Ags on a lot of heroes though now. AA finished his, as we mentioned. Windrunner looking like she's going Ida for an MKB, it's probably that, just to deal with a slight mischance on the Ankh from the Radiance, but it could also be some crit.
I'd expect MKB. The damage isn't that much lower, and the mischance can, like, lose you a kill more often than a crit will gain you a kill. I feel like. As long as Miracle doesn't let his repel drop and get instantly chainspun.
He also has a BKB now. 10-second BKB.
On top of the Aegis Slayer, I'm pretty sure they can secure Axe here unless they massively overextend.
Now they've got the fake Naga Siren. Yeah, they've got the fake Naga Siren on Alchemist, so it does put some pressure all over the map, but I don't know if it's enough.
There's no way they'll be able to, like, cut the... That's actually really smart by the Ogre. He stands on the high ground and he ends up cancelling out the smoke. They don't try and go for him, though. They just focus on their Axe.
Sentinel Stomp comes in, the Repel comes out a little bit late, but it doesn't matter, Miracle. He's still getting ready to go onto this Rax. He actually jumps forward, got a Chronosphere up the Alchem, once again, Raging Potato, gonna get caught by an AA Blast. They're trying to do something on the back lines, but there's nothing to do, and he doesn't have buyback this time. That's two down. On the back lines, they're actually getting a few kills. They're gonna get one. They might be able to get the Dazzle with the Ignite, but no, too much healing up, and now Jesse Vash going down as well. Cuckoo, he's used that Sonic Wave, he's got nothing left. A gem on the deck. And it looks like Windrunner, she's going to be able to easily take this Rax with the help of Miracle. They can take not another lane because they still have so many tier 2s up for Mineski, but...
They can definitely go bottom though. Mantle's going to clear this creep wave and TP out, but another one's coming in soon enough. They can definitely get the tier 2 as well. They might even get the tier 3 because it's 60 seconds on the Alk. And Quapulti, it's up in 2 seconds. They have Static Storm when the Disruptor spawns. So maybe they could hold the Rax.
And they still have the Aegis. So first departure, very much in control of this game. That last team fight, really devastating for Mineski. We've also got almost a 10,000 experience lead on first departure, which you might not think it's that big, but when we look at hero levels, we can just see they're doing much better. They have heroes who are level 20, level 17. So, and they're working, yeah.
On the Omni as well.
Yeah. Oh, another blue on that. This is GG. There's a Shackle to follow it up. They're going to kill off both of these heroes, and this is a Rax. They have a buyback on the Ogre. They're gonna catch out the Centaur with the AA Blast though, and he doesn't have anything else he can do. Still 12 seconds as the immediate Ogre Magi buyback. They know it's now or never on Mineski, but I think it's never. I don't think you can do anything here. They actually get Miracle to move around, really, but Cuckoo, he's falling so easily on. And there he goes down. He buys back. He doesn't have the Sonic Wave for 20 more seconds. They might be able to kill up Miracle here, but once again, that's just Aegis. In comes the Alk, seeing what he can do. They've lost a second set of ranged Rax, and now they managed to burn out the Aegis. Cuckoo going in him. He's going to get stunned up here because of the Yules. Can he get anything to save him? No, he actually gets out of it. Now they're going to manage to pick off Cal at the very least, but Miracle still going in him. There is an AA Blast. It hits on Ogre Magi. I think the Frostbite, meaning that he can't heal up on the Rage, is active. If they can kill up somebody else here, maybe it's worth it for Mineski, but I don't see them getting it. Kai goes down. Miracle is still causing so much havoc. He BKBs, so he doesn't get glimpsed away. Yeah, and Alk self-stunned because of the BKB. He's going down to Miracle. That was their buybacks. They're gonna kill off the Disruptor as well. Queen of Pain gets a kill on the other side of the team fight, but I don't think she can take out Miracle.
Yeah, he can chrono and kill her as well if she overstays.
Yeah, and he'll just casually take the next Rax. There's gonna be a Sentinel back in it, but again, he's not so worried. Sentinel actually has to be scared. Uses his stomp on him. Can they do it? They do! Well played getting that kill on Miracle. Yeah, he had also got the Mask of Madness active, so...
I was just about to say, Mineski aren't gonna GG because it's still the tier 2 tower top, but that is as close to as you're going to get, I think.
Yeah.
Obviously they're gonna try and prolong this game, but I don't think there's a way of them winning a fight when the Alk gets hit by the...
Ice Blast.
AA Blast.
Yeah.
And Miracle's getting like 2 to 3 man Chronos, just like jumping in. They're way too stacked.
Yeah. He hasn't gotten less than a 2, I think.
Except for when he's just using it for picks. His Chronos have been really good, and the follow-up's been there every time. Like, the AA Blast is always on point. The Windrunner's either killing people in the Chrono or zoning out the people who can help. So they're playing it really well.
Yeah. Lincoln's up on Omni Knight as well, so less
I actually
things...
went Lincoln's.
Yeah, less things gonna hit. They can just stack all of this up on the Faceless Void. He doesn't take damage or attacks from the enemies anymore. And this Diffusal from Sentinel, I understand its purpose, but...
It's just been negated by the Lincolns. Yeah. So, I imagine Void's gonna look to farm up at least his next item. And then they might try and go again, even before Roche. There's another 4 minutes. So they might not want to wait that long. to let the Elk maybe get his next item or two in that time.
If there...
I actually buy Refresher. They want to win now.
Okay. I like it. If there's any way for Mineski to get back into this game, how do they do it? Because I'm not seeing an easy way. I mean, I think the only way is like a lucky smoke gank where you kill the Void 5 times in a row.
Well, they don't have the buybacks to be able to tank the spells and then wipe them afterwards, so stall until buybacks are up and then hope FD use their spells like pretty badly and don't instantly wipe you, then you buyback and they overextend and you turn. But I don't think that will happen more than once, and I think they need it to happen 2 or 3 times for them to have a chance. Elk's just not fat enough, despite being like... he's still only 3k ahead, but... the hero's just not meant to be, like, unequal pegging with anyone.
He's meant to be much further ahead, and when he is not, you can see he suffers greatly for it, so... And the Refresher, as you said, they just have one more tier 2 to take, and then they take the game. It feels like a slow suffocation of Mineski here.
And it doesn't look like they want to defend the tier 2 either.
Yeah.
So they want to shove the other lanes as far as possible.
It makes sense when you're up against those big creeps, but they have to take this fight somehow.
They're going to need to wrap around and find the Dazzle or the Omni, but that's really hard. Do they have smokes? Don't think they do.
No sorcery. Yeah, all of their smokes. See. There is actually one in the Disruptor's stash, and he is getting really close to that Aghanim's. He can almost buy it. He actually sells his boots. He sells everything to buy the Aghs. And they do have a smoke on the Disruptor. Now there's gonna be the go in. Oh, he actually catches one. He catches Potato. He doesn't have buyback, I think. No, he might actually have farmed it up. I'm not quite sure. There's a second Chronosphere. Does he have buyback? He does have buyback. He's able to get back in. Miracle's gonna go down here. They managed to kill him off. So they don't actually get the Windrunner as well. They're trying their damnedest to catch her. And now on the other side of the fight, they're gonna catch up Windrunner. They're gonna catch up Dazzle. That's a fantastic hold for them. Somehow Mineski getting this. They can't stop Kai. But they killed off three. Three I didn't think they would kill.
That's exactly what needed to happen from Mineski.
Like, they have to do this like 10 times in a row.
Say again?
They have to do this like 10 times in a row to get back into the game. It's not, and as you said, now they don't have buybacks on cooldown.
But no, yeah, they can't do it again for the next 6 minutes. So they're going to have to play really well at splitting the map and only getting caught off on heroes that don't matter. So the Elk's going to have to like put his team on his back and climb up Everest here. Is under
attack. Yeah, and they're probably hoping that it is a very short Roshan. Where is Queen of Pain? She is Sonic Waving Megas, Supers, and they're going in! Can they catch out this guy again? If they kill off the Omni, he's gonna have- Oh, he doesn't manage to get off the Purification, those cost points. Alk also just gonna Manta out of that. They're getting a tier 2, I'm really impressed, and now they're going a little bit ham. If they kill off the AE here! They do! Are you kidding? They managed to get these two kills. They're going for a tier 3, and after how horrible this game has been for them, there's gonna be a self-stun. But still, nobody is up on First Departure who can fight, and they have a little bit of damage they can do to this tower. If they get a Rax, I don't think they can, but if they can get any semblance of damage on that Rax, they're smartly backing out, gonna leave the illusions and some Acid Spray to get rid of that next creep wave. Queen of Pain working on a tier 1 on bottom, but this is fantastic. I can't believe Mineski got so much out of the map just then.
That's just FD playing sloppy. They should... No, FD want to, sorry, Mineski want to do something in that time, and their supports just kind of hanging around the tier 2 was the least safe place for them to be.
Okay, now it feels like Mineski need to stall out the game another 5 minutes for buybacks. How?
And then they need to win a fight like they did before, and then stall for another 5. And rinse and repeat.
It's gonna be up soon, the Roshan. So of course, First Departure have this advantage. They have to contest it. Can they catch out this guy? They've got the Hoofstorm! They've got the Static Storm! It's the Aghanim Static Storm! He can't BKB! Miracle's going down! That's how you buy bloody 5 minutes!
Yeah, that's definitely... he's even gonna... Actually, he doesn't have buyback because he put out.
He didn't have buyback last team fight,
Rax,
so...
actually.
Oh, you think it's Rax? I'm not sure if it's Rax, but...
I mean, like, Miracle's the hero that enables him to do this shit. Windrunner does a lot of damage, but she can die. So, I think they can get Rax here for sure.
Now we're gonna be seeing if they can. If they even this up, it just delays the game so much more for Mineski, puts them in a better position. They're going in a beautiful Shackle shot. Where is the AA Blast? It's on cooldown. Is Raging Potato able to stay up? The AA Blast completely whiffs! Not quite sure what happened there. Taking a lot of damage on Raging Potato. Can he get the heal? Wonder what I need? Two more auto attacks? Gonna blink in and get them, but at the same time, what is the status of the Rax? The Rax is only at half health. They need to do something to it, but they're shackled again! These shackle shots of Windrun are playing out of her mind, and I think Mineski, again, put themselves in maybe not the best position. Jesse gets a multi-cost, but Windrun finally goes down. Quap trying to do what she can. Cuckoo, he needs to kill off the AA, he needs to kill off Cal as well. There's gonna be a Yule's up. Let's see if Quap can do anything here. Has the purification, does manage to pick off. No, where's the AA? He's gone! Cuckoo, you need to get out of here, but he's not going to be able to. And now it is up to Disruptor. He's like, oh gosh, team, what have we done? He needs one more hit. He gets it. Immediate TP out. Do they have the damage? Will he get... Oh.
Maybe if he dropped this status storm and then TP'd, he would have lived.
Auto attacks might have done it, though. He was really low.
Yeah. I guess. There's actually a lot of damage on this tier 3 top. They need to defend this. And this is a tier 4 unless someone buys one. Okay, Disruptor does it, so he's gonna draw the aggro.
Yeah,
save his tier 4.
I mean, Disruptor doesn't need items, he's rebought his boots. He's, rebought a cape. I'm sorry.
Yeah, buying the axe was, like, really smart. Many players would sell all their items, but he understood the situation. Unfortunately, FD are now gonna scout Roche, I hope, and then they're gonna take it. And buybacks are gonna be up in time. Oh no, wait, it's 3 minutes on the Elk. So they could probably force it before Elk has buyback.
And as you point out, I have to say I really respect Disruptor here for selling everything to buy that. It won them the team fight in base, and it also helped them kill off Miracle later. Like, a lot of people were like, I can just wait.
So big.
Yeah. But again, this is gonna be Aegis. Buyback status is not, so they have to win a team fight, Mineski, with buybacks on. Yeah, buybacks on Quap, that's what they got. And suddenly buybacks on all of First Departure with the Roshan kill. So.
Yeah, this is really hard for Mineski now. I would be surprised if FD do the same thing where they go behind the towers to try and get kills with the Chrono. I think they just need to be a bit more disciplined and siege it out.
I think everybody involved in this game needs to be more disciplined.
Now, well, they did really well until like this one dive here, but that's just them feeling their strength and not respecting the buybacks.
Yeah, look at this net worth graph. It's like whoop 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 whoop. Okay, let's see. We gotta get into serious casting mode. They're going on the tower. They have the focus fire. They pop the glyph. They've got Miracle. He pops BKB because he had the repel on him and he's getting out that disruptor, but I don't know. He's stopping work on the disruptor knowing he doesn't need it, and there's a second ult, and they also got the beautiful shackle and Cuckoo. Can they do anything here? They have no buybacks on the three who are down. Let's see if this out can do any sort of thing. He has Manta up in two. He'll probably pop that for some sort of defense. They're gonna be mega though, I think, here. Sonic Wave, beautiful, but the immediate Guardian Angel, and they are stunned up, but they're not taking enough damage. Cuckoo needs to blink out, but can she get the blink out? She does manage to get away. And now it is up to Alf. Oh gosh, yeah, the Rax is going down. They are gonna get megged, but of course they do have an Alk with a Radiance. I don't know, they have Sonic Wave as well. Quap, she's maybe gonna fall. No, she blinks away, but there's the blink onto her! And that's Mega's buyback only on the Quap, and that's the GG. We're going to a game 3.
That was really well played by FD overall.
Yeah, very well played.
They understood how to counter what Mineski were doing.
So, a good game from them, and I'm excited to see us into a third game. It feels like First Departure, both games, much stronger early game. Last game, they couldn't quite translate it into the win. This game, they did. Do you try to pick differently if you're Mineski next game? What's your plan?
I definitely think you don't Elk into AA. They know that doesn't